Caution, yes. Shard, shards of glass. So we're trying to bring this guy back to life.
Those are jeans.
Worse than we thought, actually. The patient is on life support. And we have a heartbeat. And we're going to try to rehab it and have a training for the Olympics soon. So, can I work here, Amy, or you have
a...
Okay, I'm disabled. All squirrel or sable? When is he leaving?
He's in the National Portrait Gallery today, and then he's going back. He's going to get back
in. Oh, okay. Is it cool? Trying to bring this guy back to life. So good. Now this is going to be a challenging area here. So we'll have to do a complete wash on that whole situation there. That's just going to be interesting. every layer of watercolor you put down, every glaze, it gets more and more defined. So what I'm gonna have to do in other areas is actually put another glaze on to even up the amount of layers I have. So it's actually, it can only get better. You know, with the amount of layers I'm gonna have to put on, it'll just make the whole thing better. I wish I didn't have to, but this is where we are. So, I don't have really too much to go. I am trying to lay in my broader washes for now, so they can set up, and then I can go in and do some tweaking. I mean, any day that I can paint or create, no matter if I'm fixing something or creating for the first time, it's a good day for me. This is awesome. Sensibility. And he was like a sponge when I was there for the week of a workshop in Atlanta. And he wanted to learn every single thing he could learn about painting. And we got along really, really, really well. So, trying to bring Gray back to life here. Now, this area is going to be very interesting. Now, this is a dry brush technique, which erasing the clock, but I'm going to do as much as I possibly can to
Thank you.
what an art restore feels like.
I'm following the footsteps of an artist. Luckily, this is my own art, which makes it easier. Not a dead guy.
Now, what do you think about the actual watercoloring?
It's a wonderful medium. It's good for getting quick ideas down without overworking them, you know, like with other mediums. But as far as retouching, I would much prefer to do this in oil or pastel, which lends itself to much more working and reworking. With watercolor, it's very temperamental, and it has staining and pooling properties that don't lend themselves to retouching. For instance, in this area, I laid down the gray to block in. Now I'm gonna have to go over it with a wash, with the white, to bring it up. So there's just a lot of layering involved with retouching. But as far as a medium, I love it. It's one of my favorites to look at. Not just my art, anybody's art. It's wonderful and it's translucent. And it captures light like no other medium has the ability to do. Here, it's gonna have to get dry brushed also.
We really did a job with this glass. This glass really tore this piece up.
Okay,
so I think we're pretty much done. It's gonna dry lighter. Once it comes up, it'll all even out, especially this area here.
It's been intensely dry brushed, so it'll blend in and it'll dry probably two or three shadow values lighter. And I don't know if we have a before and after shot of it, but it's definitely come back to life and he's ready to go. So.
Go ahead.
I have something similar that is all little tiny pieces.
Piece is officially restored.
So
just said this morning, we're gonna come and bring it back to life. He's officially resuscitated.
Yeah,
and over here.
Yeah,
good buddy. I'm a happy camper.